says she misses her sons, who are now in a shelter in New York. As for Idalia and the migrants who are stuck in this dangerous plaza in Reynosa,
are you scared?
See,
their American dream is still alive, despite having to sleep in shifts to watch each other's backs. And if you're sitting at home wondering, how is it possible that these mothers make this decision to send their children into the United States alone, you've got to think of it this way. Some of these mothers have been returned into areas like Reynosa, and they're there with their children, but they are surrounded by danger, exposed and vulnerable to kidnapping, extortion, human trafficking. And then they learn that the Biden administration is allowing unaccompanied minors to enter into the U.S. And Aaron, they see that as giving their children a chance at life. Aaron?
Marissa, thank you very much. A powerful report. And thanks so much to all of you, as always, for being with me. Anderson starts now.
As we speak, a curfew has just taken effect in and around Minneapolis and St. Paul, including here in Brooklyn Center, Minnesota. Mourners and protesters not going anywhere at the moment. The outpouring and curfew come in response to civil unrest after police in this Minneapolis suburb shot and killed a black man, Dante Wright, during a traffic stop over the weekend. Just moments ago, the county medical examiner ruled his death a homicide. It was not the only item along those lines, though. Also over the weekend, video emerged of an Army lieutenant pepper sprayed and roughed up by police outside Norfolk, Virginia, after admitting he was too terrified to get out of his car during a traffic stop late last year. "I'm honestly afraid to get out," he's heard to say. In response, one of the officers tells him, "Yeah, you should be." And as if to emphasize that fear cuts both ways, two police officers were shot and wounded early this morning during a high-speed chase west of Atlanta. All of this, of course, is happening with the Twin Cities already on edge as the prosecution continues to make its case against a former Minneapolis police officer in the killing of George Floyd. President Biden spoke to the moment and the mood this afternoon.